Good morning, everyone. It's 6 a.m. on day four of spring, four out of six, and boy, do we have a lot of work to do. Last night after, or actually yesterday afternoon after I left you guys, I think I had a bite to eat around 3 o'clock. Then I got right back on the tractor, and I had to clear this field because we need to plow it. We need to plow it ASAP. So I pushed all the logs from this field up against the edges. I loaded up a couple of wagons full and sort of did some busy work. So this is actually going to be an excellent but absolutely massive field. So I've got these guys here. I've loaded up a bunch because I've got another trip to do in. No point in driving to town without bringing logs. And I got a pile there, I got a pile here, I got a pile on the trailer. Yeah, we got lots of logging. Another couple of things that I did, I was able to sell off another bunch of logs, so made a little bit of money. And had some think about my whole cow silage situation. The silage cost $15,000 for 8 bales. So what I did was, I brought in some grass. I brought in some grass and I dumped it in the silo. I'm going to lose 2 days productivity because this is going to take 2 days to ferment. And I'm going to lose 2 days productivity on my cows of them not being at 100%. But hang on 1 second. The good news is they have grass. So we're good there. All right. We need to do some cleanup around here too. The girls have been messy with their food, so we need to clean that up at some point. But I think for now, they'll hold. We didn't get them until noon yesterday anyway. We still got a bunch of bales, so we'll be good for a while for that. Hang on a second. Doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-boo. And doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. Oh, missed two. Come on. Come on. There you go. These girls really need a chicken coop. So, I also went shopping. I had to bring the grass back up, so I got my very favorite trailer in the whole wide world. I also picked up a bucket, because for silage, I picked up one of these cleaning brushes here for the animal food to clean up around the animals. This thing is weird, though. It turns the food into manure. So, which is okay, I guess, but it's when grass is rare, it's kind of annoying that I don't get to reuse the grass. Anyway. I was using Jerry's shelves, so my fork is up there. I'm just playing around generally. The other thing too is Mr. Tractor here was getting a little filthy, so we got a pressure washer. Settles that. And what else? Okay. So for today's job, we're going to need to get a stump grinder. We need to grind the stumps in that on that field. And then we're going to need to plow it under. I can't afford to wait that much longer for the... hang on a second. Just put that down. There you go. I can't afford to wait any longer, and I need to get stuff done. So let's start by... How much is it going to cost for me to do some maintenance on this? Alt-R. So we got $35 of maintenance to be done on this. Yes, let's get it done. We don't want this thing breaking down on us. It is our workhorse, and we need to take care of her. The other one is Okay, customizing. We are going to add the front hydraulics to it. We had it sort of as a weight, but the front hydraulics are going to be handy because in first person, grinding stumps, best done in first person with the front hydraulics. So we're not paying any more for installation because this is a toolbox mod. That basically just allows you to just do your work wherever you need to. So, you get out from underneath there. It does the usual thing where it bounces your tractor when you do stuff, but anyway, it's not important. So drop that there, stoop down, pick it up, put it back on the table. I don't really need to do that because as soon as I reset the game, that's where it's going back. Anyway, so now we got front hydraulics on the tractor. We are golden. Oh yeah, let me give you a quick look at our money situation. Ta-da! Look at that. $93,000 we have in the bank. Yesterday after I left you guys, I just grind through that wood. I made 147, almost 40, $147,000. It's just yesterday was really just pushing logs out of that field. Had to be done. I was on until about 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, working in the dark, but had to be done. And let's get moving. So I'm going to put this weight on the front of the tractor to balance it out because I have a feeling that those logs, without a front fork on and without everything that I usually carry on the front of this thing, those logs are definitely going to be pushing me down that hill. Oh yeah, I added manual attach too, because this was just not hard enough. Okay, I'm gonna head to the field. Out of the way, chickens. Hello, excuse me, coming through. I'm gonna head to the field, grab that trailer, and we're gonna make a run for the town. Okay, that was good. That heavy trailer sure gives you a push down that hill. You know what? We never go this way. Let's go this way. Sweet, another $17,000. We're up to $111,000. We haven't even planted stuff yet. So let's put her over here. We'll come back for her when it's time to print more money, really. Oh, yeah. Pro tip, take the weights off the front before you do this. Ah, much better. So, stump grinder, $5,000. Yes, please, we are buying that. For that price? Yeah, no problem. So that one will go on the case. Now, we need to think about plowing. This small plow I love. It's a five furrow. And it's an absolute joy. It's not reversible. You have to go down one side of the field, up the other, yada, yada, yada. But if you just enjoy plowing for the joy of plowing, that's one of my favorites. This is really cool because it's a subsoiler. And I don't know, like, technically speaking, should we be subsoiling the soil because those fields have never, ever been used? Well, they haven't been used in at least 10 years. This one needs 170 horsepower, though, and we've only got about, woo, maybe 80 on the case. Yep, buying it. Good, thank you. Now, the big decision comes along. Up here, 88 horsepower. It takes a while before we bump into something that's going to be able to pull 170 horsepower. No. This guy there. Okay, we're in this zone here. So 104, 165 is still too small. So we're looking at JCB, T Series, Massey Ferguson. But look at those prices. So we have other options down here in the mod world. Case XL, it's a little small for what we're trying to do, although they're flat fields, so I'm pretty sure she would do it. She'd easily push it. And 43,000 is hard to turn away from. The fence, 70 horsepower. I like these little guys here. They're beautiful. Here's the deal. I need to get this done, and I'm most probably, while I'm up to the at the top field prepping stuff, I'm going to hire somebody to do it for me on the lower end. So this guy, 81,000, twin wheels, no, 78,000. Okay, well that'll take all our money. But you know what I can do? I can take this guy, we can use it for a day or two, repair him, fix him up, clean him up, and then sell him back. Will probably end up costing us about $10,000. We'll keep an eye on the price, 78,000, and see how much money we can make back when we buy him back. So I'm gonna buy him. Oh, look at this monster. It's gorgeous. It's a beautiful machine. Yes, machine. Oh. Originally designed to haul intercontinental ballistic missiles, but does really well hauling a plow. Anyway, let's go for it. Feel the power. Ah, yeah. Oh, that's a monster. Lift her up. Good girl. Okay. God, it's an animal. It's an animal. Okay, now, next step is that's just funny that I hop out on this side. Look at the size of those things. Yes, love it. Okay. Okay, so now I just need to hook this guy up to our good old-fashioned stump grinder. That should do it. Yes. Bring it up so it doesn't hit anything. Yeah, traffic's gonna love us. We got a waggly tail. Okay. Now, we need to hire a worker for this thing to get her back to the shop or to the farm. And hang on a second. All right, so where do we pick up a worker? Oh, I know. Okay, it's 7:30 in the morning. I'm gonna go and grab a bite to eat, and while I do that, I am going to see if anybody wants to work today. All right, guys, meet Jenny. She's been around this neighborhood for a long time. The guys tell me she knows what she's doing. So we are going to give her some money today and see if she can help us out. Now the trick with this is always when you got people following you, you gotta not only leave enough room for yourself, but for the staff member too. Okay, no cars coming. She can make it out. Oh dear, here he comes. Come on. Come on. There you come. Okay, good. We're safe for now. All right, so we're gonna run with traffic on this one. If I'm in the flow of traffic, there's less of a chance that we're gonna get in trouble back there. So, give me a couple of seconds here, guys. I'm just going to get her started and we'll be off. All right. So, letting a total stranger with a plow loose in my fields. What could possibly go wrong? Okay. So, the next field we're going to need to do is the field at the top of the hill. So, we got some stump grinding to do. Let's have at it. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, where's the first stumps? Those guys there. Yeah, we'll start here. We'll do this side, and then I'll move over to that side where the most of them are. So, first things first, Attach the PTO. Lift her up. Give her a start. I don't know. We need to lower it, I think, so I can see what I'm doing. Alright, I just like to do them this way because that way I can line them up with my front wheel, look behind me, wait for the stump grinder to start acting on it. Oops, back up a bit. There you go. And then just grind it all down. And then go to the next one. Okay, well, you guessed it. We'll be at this for a while. This is honestly one of those jobs where you need to have an open cab, because especially with, I use track IR, and you can just lean over, see what you're doing, you can hear it engage, you get some sense of what you're doing and where the placement of the stump is. I can't imagine doing this if you're in a Fendt or one of the quiet tractors where the sound is so deadened on the inside. This thing here, you get a real sense of what you're doing. You get a real sense of work. And there will be lots of them. Okay, just gonna switch back here. I just wanna double check to see if I'm on the right line. There's a lot of these wood chips here are leftovers from, oh, there's one. A lot of these wood chips are leftovers from me chopping up the logs to put them on the trailer last night. That's sort of throwing off my game. I should have cleared all of them off. And before I started chopping them up, so that the stumps would all be sitting in their own individual little piles of sawdust. But, you know, I got into making money and wasn't thinking ahead. My bad. Hunting, 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 ah, bingo. Oh, this one's a little bit high. There he is. Got them all, yep, got them all the way down. Good. Just gonna lower this as much as I can, there you go. I felt that one. Where are you? There he is. Do I have any more on this side? No. Okay, I usually like to do this in first person and just, you know, carry on like this, but this is a video, and I'm pretty sure you guys are gonna get sick and tired of me looking over my shoulder for no reason. There's a strange glitch in Farm Sim that basically wherever you place the trees, sometimes the actual point for the grinder to get to is just off to one side. I have no idea how that works or why that works, but anyway. Mine is not the judge, I just need to grind my stumps. Ah, I know what this is. Oh, hang on a second. Safety first. That's one of my magical discs. We'll just leave that over here. And when we go down to the wood shop, we'll sell that for 2 cents. Whoa! Holy, wait a minute. Is she already done down there? Okay, we'll go down and check on Jenny and see if it's really all done. And then we'll come back to these games. All right, let's see here. Up here, I think. Look at that. She made a field. Wow. Okay, well, you know, in a usual course play style, they don't get everything, but I mean, come on. That's amazing. Okay, I'm going to finish off this field and then gonna move her on to the next one. And yeah, we'll see what we can do. But at this speed, looks like we're gonna be grinding a whole lot more than she's plowing. Okay, well, turns out Jen had to go because frankly, the only other field that I want to do today is this one here, and I'm not ready for her. So, the real story is I want to do some plowing too. So I don't really feel like just setting the whole thing on automatic. That was a bit of a mistake. Let's just carry on. And start her up. Lower her down. Back in position. And off we go. Yeah, I feel like I need a little bit more weight on the front there, because it was starting to jiggle around. Now you might ask, am I using some sort of system to figure out which stump to get next? Absolutely not. I'm just driving around, and if I see him, I stump him. Hunting, hunting, hunting. Found one. This one looks like it's got a frisbee. I can just imagine you guys look going, there's one, and I'm just completely missing it. But it's not a big deal, because the curvets will plow through a lot of stuff. We'll keep this guy handy so that we can cut, we can erase the ones that we may have missed. Wow, okay, well, that was actually far more productive than I thought it would be. Let's just get a couple of extra ones on this field that we got out before we formulated an actual plan. Let's see, come on, show your head. That one? Yep, there's one here. That's excellent. Okay. You'll have to excuse me. I'm going to go into Skyview. I'm going to launch the drone. Okay, well, I'm not sure at all that we got them all, but it'll do for now. So let's, you know what? It's about lunchtime anyway, so I think I'm going to take a break here and have lunch. I think this guy here needs to be refueled anyway, so I'm going to take advantage of the gasoline we've got left on the farm. Hey, whoa, 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 guys. We've already made more eggs. Okay, he put a nice little fuel station for us here. Always extinguish your engine before refueling. That's just safety. Okay, and and she's absolutely filthy, but yeah, she's a working tractor. She's not a showroom queen. So, and restart. just going to leave her here where she's out of the way. Going to put this down. Going to lower it. Lower it. Okay. Turn everything off. Weights off the front. Yes. Okay. Yeah, that'll stay like that for a little while. Okay. So, our next job is we are going to plow this. The reason why I had the other field plowed is because it's a big enough field. I think that the one down there is going to be my silage field. The only concern I have about it is that it may end up being too far away because I'm always already having issues getting up that driveway. So it may be a problem, but when it happens, maybe we'll hang on to Mr. Kuravets here so that we can get up the hill with the silage. I don't know. Or maybe we'll just get smaller trailers for the case. Yeah. Either way, we're gonna need to come up with a plan for how we're gonna harvest that silage. It won't be with a forage harvester, that's for sure. Those things are $500,000 a pop, and there's no way we're getting that much money before the end of the year. So, yeah, I think I'm gonna leave you here on this episode, and I am going to come back after lunch, and I'm gonna plow this field here. And any extra time I have today will be taken up going down with this little guy again. And we still need to grind all the stumps for the trees at the bottom of the hill. So once again, thanks for joining me. And yeah, I'll talk to you soon.